stop sign.
And it's going to stick around for another 48 hours. And then we think towards the end of the week, we may have to watch the tropics, guys. We'll talk more about that straight ahead. Easy now. All right, Daytona Beach, going back to Chad. Father's Day this weekend, keeping with that beach theme. If you're headed there tomorrow, you heard Claire. A lot of youngsters are off. A lot of folks headed to the beach. And why not? Gorgeous weather. But please be careful. Right through the middle of this week and potentially even beyond that. We'll have to watch that wind flow later this week. But right now, we've got high pressure over the upstate of South Carolina. And with high pressure that close and this strong for this time of the year, that's why we've got an elevated rip current risk right through at least the middle of the week. Look at the temperatures outside. We have cooled to 85 degrees now downtown with that onshore flow. Still sitting at 90 Ocala, down from 90 to 88 now over towards the villages. Very comfortable out there despite those warm temperatures. We'll show you why here in a second. Winds are out of the east, northeast, at about 10 to 15 miles an hour. And there have been a few gusts as high as 20 to 25 miles an hour. Now, we do have a few ongoing brush fires into Osceola County, so we'll watch that. But when we measure the amount of moisture in the air mass today, it is awfully low, 50s and low 60s. Very comfortable for this time of the year. Very unusual for this time of the year as well, I might add. It's going to make for a pleasant evening. If you're cooking outside tonight, you're in great shape. Look at that midnight temperature coming in at about 72, 7 a.m. coming in at about 70 degrees. The setup for tonight, another gorgeous evening. Maybe a stray coastal sprinkle. We've seen a few of them offshore. That should die down over towards sunset. Skies will clear later on tonight. Overnight low temperature in Ocala falling to 66 degrees. Downtown Orlando, again, below that 70-degree mark. Average low, by the way, for this time of the year, should be running in the lower 70s. And then we take you out towards the tropics. We're not worried about this particular feature, but there is a swirl over the warm Gulf Stream there, northeast of Bermuda. Does have a chance to become crisp over the next 24 to 48 hours if it can get its act together. We're really not worried about anything out there. Potentially down the road, though, we'll have to watch this disturbance. Some of the computer models are hinting at potential low pressure forming in the southwestern Bay of Campeche. But for us, in the short run, there is a little bit of moisture across South Florida tomorrow night. And then on into Wednesday, we think that some of that shower activity will spread farther north into Polk, Osceola, and into Brevard County. So get out there and enjoy tomorrow. Afternoon high temperatures there running right around 85 to 90. Inland, mid-80s as you take it towards the beach. 7-day forecast here for you, 74, 83, 87. Just a 10% chance for an afternoon shower. On Wednesday, rain chances going up for the first day of summer, coming in at about 90 degrees. Looking ahead to Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, rain chances getting back to normal. Afternoon highs also at par right around 91, 92.
Thanks, Tony.